Today's topic is consignment. Consignment accounts. Under this topic, we'll learn about the meaning of consignment, what are the features, and we identify the difference between the consignment and sale, and different types of commissions. Okay, under that, ordinary commission, delk raider commission, overriding commission, we will know the different types of commissions. Next is value of unsold stock with the consignee. Value of unsold stock with the consignee. So, and we will learn journal entries. Okay, based on the journal entries, we'll do the problems. Now first we write the meaning of consignment. Consignment is a consignment is the sending of goods a consignment is the sending of goods by sending of goods by one merchant to sending of goods by one merchant to another one merchant to another merchant or one person to another person, either within the country or abroad. In the country or abroad. For what purpose? Abroad, for the purpose of storage. For the purpose of storage and their ultimate sale. Storage and their ultimate sale. Ultimate sale on commission. Ultimate sale on commission basis at the risk of risk of the sender himself. now see here, consignment is means what? Consignment is a sending of goods by one person to another person, either within the country or outside the country, for the purpose of storage and their ultimate sale. So they'll get commission on the sale. Their ultimate sale on commission basis at the risk of the sender himself. So under this, in simple words, this consignment business is an extension to the direct sale system. Okay, it is a direct sale system. So unlike direct sales, indirect sales are made through an agent. Okay, sales are made through an agent who is appointed on a commission basis. Okay, agent means what? Third person. Okay, that third persons are appointed on the commission basis. They will expect some commission. So the system of indirect selling is known as an consignment. Okay. So under this, where one person sends goods to the other person to be on the commission basis. Okay, so here two parties are under that. One party is one party is consignor, or principal, okay, one party is a consignor or principal, and second party is consignee or the agent. Okay, these are the two parties are there. Who are the two parties? One is consignor and second person is consignee. Consignee means the person who sends goods is called as an consignor or principal. Okay, who sends goods? Okay, that is called as an consignor. Consignee or agent means who receives the goods. Okay, here the consignor sends the goods to the consignee. Here is this person is send the goods to the consignee. So he is receiving the goods from the consignor. Okay, the relationship between consignor and consignee is principal and agent relationship. Remember this, the relationship between the consignor and consignee is principal and agent. Next is the person or the firm sending the goods is called as a principal or consignor. The person from receiving the goods is called as an agent or consignee. So the accounts relating to the consignment transactions are called as an consignment accounts. Here we wrote now consignment account. So what is consignment accounts? The accounts relating to the consignment transaction, sending the goods, receiving the goods, how much is the commission. So different transactions will be there now. So the accounts relating to consignment transactions are called as an consignment accounts. For example, a book publishing company may send books to agents, that is agents are bookshops, at other places for selling them on a commission basis. Hence the publishing company is called as an consignor and bookshops are called as an consignee. Now what is the difference between the consignment and sales? Also the goods, one person sending the goods and other person receiving the goods. Okay, so now what is the difference between consignment and sales? The difference between consignment and sale is, the first difference is ownership. Ownership. Next is physical position. Physical position. Next is risk. Risk. The next is relationship. Relationship. Next is return of goods. Return of goods. Next is sale price. So these are the main differences between the consignment and sale. Now we will briefly explain. First one is what ownership. So under the sales, according to the Sale of Goods Act 1930, where the property in goods is transferred from the seller to the buyer is called as an sale. Okay, under that sale two parties are there now. One is seller and the other one is buyer. Okay, under that property in goods, not goods, property. Okay, where the property in goods is transferred from the seller to the buyer, so that contract is called as an sale. Under this consignment. But in consignment, properties or ownership both are same. property of goods remain with the consignor. Only the physical position of the goods are sending to the consignee. Okay, under the sale, ownership of the goods are transferred from the seller to the buyer. But under the consignment, ownership is remains with the consignor. Only the goods are sending to the consignee. The next second one is physical position. So in case of sale, position of goods. Position of goods, that is delivery of goods, may or may not be transferred to the buyer immediately. But in consignment, physical position of the goods is essential. Next is risk. Third one is risk. So under the sales, risk attached to the goods will be passed from the seller to the buyer as soon as a transfer takes place. Okay, so risk is there while sending the goods from that. So under the sale, that risk of the goods will be passed from the seller to the buyer. Therefore, any loss is there in the sale, any loss is incurred, that is to be borne by the purchaser. But in case of consignment, any loss or any damages to the goods in transport or storage is to be borne by the consignor, not by the consignee. Even though the goods are physically transferred to the consignee. Why? Because borne by consignor. Because ownership of the goods is consignor only. No? So that's why any loss is incurred, that should be borne by the consignor in consignment. Under the sale, any risk or any loss is incurred, that should be borne by the purchaser or the buyer, not on a seller. Okay, next one is relationship. Next one is relationship. So in case of sale, the relationship between the seller, and buyer is that of creditor and debtor. Whereas in case of consignment, the relationship between consignor and consignee is a principal and agent. Next is return of goods. In case of sale, the buyer cannot return the goods to the seller. Under the sale, the buyer cannot return the goods to the seller except for special reasons such as damage, wrong quality of goods, but in consignment the consignee can always return the goods to the consignor if they cannot sold. So here consignor send some goods to the consignee. Okay, so by the end of this month, how much you can sold that all the goods. If remaining any stock is there, so that should be returned to the consignor. Okay, so that is a return of goods. Next is sale price. Next is sale price. So in case of sale, the buyer can sell the goods at any price as per his wish, or he can use the goods for himself only. Okay, in case of sale, the buyer can sell the goods at any price as per his wish. Okay, but in consignment, the consignee has to sell the goods as per the terms and conditions specified by the buyer. The consignee sold the goods as he is not himself. Okay, so the consignee should follow the terms and conditions he specified by the consignor. But in sale, the seller can thus sell the goods at any price as per his own wish. Next is features of consignment. Next is features of consignment. So, first feature is the consignor sends goods to consignee to be sold on commission basis on behalf of the consignor. For example, on this day, the consignor sends the goods to the consignee 1500 units. Okay, within the 5 days these units are sold to the customers, I will give 2% commission to you, 5% commission to you. Okay, that is an a sale on commission. Okay, under this, the consignor sends goods to the consignee to be sold on the commission basis. Okay, this is the first feature. Next is the consignor enjoys the profit or bears loss resulted on consignment business. If any profit is incurred, that should be bear by the consignor, or if any loss is there, that should also bear by the consignor. Both the consignor enjoys the profit or bears the losses. Okay, depending on his business. Next is third feature is the consignee sells the goods on behalf of the consignor. Okay, the consignor sells the goods on behalf of the consignor. The consignee sells the goods on behalf of whom? Mm-hmm. On behalf of the consignor, and get commission on the sale proceeds. Next feature is the consignor bears all expenses and losses on consignment.
The consignor bears all expenses on losses on consignment by himself or consignee. Next is, while remitting the sale proceeds, the consignee will have the right to deduct his commission. Okay, the consignee have the right to deduct that commission and his expenses on the consignment. So, if while selling the goods, so the consignee also should incur some expenses. So, that expenses also deducted.